God is so good. Tell us about what he means to you.
He is my soul and my light and drives me every day. And I want to follow him in the right direction. And I want to follow God's will. I really want to change who I am inside. And I want to help other people in every way.
That's so exciting. You came right up to me and said, I just don't do anything. I want to do something.
Yes.
What has brought this change about in your life?
Well, I've been praying to God and asking him to use me as he will. Mm-hmm. Like really asking him, please use me as you will. And then my dear husband found the link on Facebook.
Yes.
And he said, let's do this. Now, at the first start of Christmas, we were just going to go have a modest meal by ourselves because it's just us. And then he said, look at this, honey. I said, ooh. I said, this is from God, then. Let us do this, because I have never done anything like this, and I want to learn to be self-sacrificing.
So this is exciting to see her excitement over this.
Oh, it's totally exciting.
Yes,
it's totally exciting.
It's like the Holy Spirit is just really working, and, you know, Jesus is moving.
Praise the Lord.
We give him the glory and the honor, and it's just so exciting because, you know, you can't just do nothing once the Holy Spirit does his work and the love of Jesus starts flowing in you.
Mm-hmm.
He said, let your light so shine before men and women they might see your good works and glorify our Father who is in heaven. Isn't
right.
that exciting?
Exactly. Exactly. And my wife and I, we got married a little over 7 months ago.
Oh, wow.
And she's a new believer. And it's just amazing because my testimony is 12 years ago, I was homeless.
Yes.
And it was only through the Lord that I was able to get back. I bought a townhome 2 years ago. I've been in my job for almost 12 years. So the Lord has really done a work in my life in bringing this beautiful woman in. But I tell her she so much has the advantage because with me, I didn't have that support group of people, so I kind of had to go on my own. But I'm seeing her walk just growing in leaps and bounds. And I'm very, very jealous because I didn't have that, and now she does. But I'm just seeing such a Proverbs 31 woman just open up right in front of me almost overnight. And it's absolutely, I give all the glory to God for that.
And that's why we got to be soul winners, because if we've been at it for a long time, we need the enthusiasm of your new believers.
You're wonderful. You're wonderful. You're really doing God's will.
We want to just do his will. Well, I love him. And I'm just so excited that you want to help and let his light and love flow in you and through you.
Yes, if I had gazillion dollars, I'd help you build a lot of places. No, I'd build sanctuaries for people who don't have anything and help them with job placement and clothes and a house.
Well, you might have the politicians madder at you than they are at me.
Okay.
Because a lot of people don't, not in my neighborhood, they say, you know.
Well, I would if I had all that.
There's a spiritual battle that's going on right now.
Right, there is.
And I thank God for those that are catching the vision, those that are sharing, those that are getting involved, letting their light shine right now for the glory of God.
I'm here with Audrey, right? And who's the little girl?
Justice.
Hi, Justin. How you doing?
She's shy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so listen. How did you meet New Life? How did you come to New Life?
I was homeless, and I had gave the homeless shelter hotline a call, and a woman put me through with Ms. Linda. Ms. Linda had gave me a phone call, and she had told me that it was a bed available for me and my son to come to, and she picked us up downtown at the library, and we've been with them ever since.
So how's your experience been with New Life?
It's a struggle, but I wake up every day grateful that I'm here, that I got my kids, that I'm able to see my kids and hold them and touch them and talk to them. So I'm blessed.
It's better than
what it was before, because I didn't know where me and my son was gonna go. Like, we could have still be out on the street at this moment, and now it's cold. So I feel for the mothers and the homeless people that's out there, that's in the cold, that don't have nowhere to go.
Right. Now, if you happen to be seeing this program and you have a person that you know that's a woman with or without children that needs a place to go, we ask you to call us at 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020 and ask for Linda. And she will give you all the information that you need. And you also, we have two more things we want to talk about real quick. Mm-hmm. Okay. You have joined the program.
Yes, sir.
Now, I should tell you what the program is. The program is a way that we are taking men and women into what was called a leadership program where they will come into a Christian community. They have a roof over their heads, mm-hmm. right? Room and board is paid for. And they're going to teach you more about God, mm-hmm. walk you into God, walk a closer and deeper walk with God.
Yeah.
Right. So how's the program working for you now?
It's working very good. Not saying that I wasn't in church when I was younger, but now it's getting me closer to God, getting me to actually know myself and getting my kids involved too. So,
well, it makes a big difference because when the kids find out who mama runs to, mm-hmm. when things get bad, they'll do the same thing, mm-hmm. right? So in a time of crisis, whoever you run to becomes your God.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is teach our kids as an example mm-hmm. to run to God first in everything that we do.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Another thing we got to talk about is your new baby.
Yes, Journey.
Okay. And there's a story behind that.
Yes, right. Okay. I was working so much, and at the time I was working, I wasn't eating correctly, but my weight was shifting up and down, and for me to be a mother of three and not know that I was pregnant, it was a big shocking, but also a big blessing, too, because I got a beautiful baby girl out of it.
Right, she is beautiful, and the story that I got was that you were going to the hospital because you felt it was food poisoning.
Yes.
Right, mm-hmm. and then you felt it was something else.
Uh-huh.
Right? You didn't know what it was.
No, and right? then I went to the hospital and 10-14 popped out a 7-pound, 13-ounce baby.
Right. And she's beautiful. Her name is Journey.
Yes, sir.
Well, we want to thank you, Audrey, for being here. Okay. But thank you for your dedication and volunteerism for the program.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And we want to thank you also for giving us an opportunity to show you the love of Jesus.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank
I
you.
Appreciate that.
All right. Bye-bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Go. I want you to get a copy of the book, Through
oh,
the Fire.
Oh, I love
okay?
this. Thank you so much. God bless
that.
You.
And yes, and we just want to share that with you. And what you'll see from that book is a lot of personal stuff where I was in my, you know, as you're walking with Jesus and everybody's coming at you and everybody's attacking you. Just how you got to take it to God in prayer, and so you'll see the highlights from 2012 to the present, and you'll see the times that you just really got to call out on the Lord, because a lot of times you're out of the clouds and you're right here in the valleys, and you have to know He is there, right?
But also, the bigger the battles, the bigger the victories.
That's right.
You know, and with God, we already know who's won the major battles.
We've got to keep looking to Him.
It's Him. Yeah. It's Him. And, you know, it's just to run a good race.
Amen.
You know, and we've got to keep running that race. We can't stop.
You know? Continue. The Bible says those that remain steadfast to the end, the same shall be saved. So as you see the last 6 years of ours just trying to hang on and looking to Jesus, maybe it will help you in your spiritual growth.
And if I ever get gazillion dollars, I'm going to come back and we can build something.
Well, you just pray. Our Father owns the cattle on a thousand
That's
hills,
right.
okay?
That's right, because I could help and build those places.
In the meantime, you can just keep calling out unto the Lord and believe and pray, because we need prayer warriors on the front lines,
right,
okay?
Right,
just
okay.
Also, sometimes it's just reaching out to one person at a time.
That's right.
You know, Rome wasn't built in a day, you know, and if every person you touch is a spiritual brick, that house will be built in no time.
Yes. So, and I thank God for all of you that are praying for the work of New Life Evangelistic Center right now, just letting your lights shine as you're letting the love and the power of Christ flow in you and through you. What a mighty God we serve. And how I thank God for those that are testifying to the goodness of God right now.
I'm joined here with Ronald. And Ronald, we've known each other for a little while now,
yes.
right? You were instrumental in holding up signs for us to acknowledge the homelessness and the homeless.
Yeah.
Right? Are you presently homeless right now?
No, I'm staying with somebody right now.
It's good to hear. I know when I first met you were homeless.
No, you know what I'm saying? There's a whole lot of homeless people need somewhere to go because, you know what I'm saying, they're trying to get...
Right. You also participate in our Friday rallies.
Sometimes.
Okay.
I ain't gonna say all the time because this Friday where I didn't come.
Okay. So what do you think? Why do you think people are homeless?
They make the wrong choice. To, you know what I'm saying, move out their mama house.
Okay.
You know, I mean, they need to quit. They need to get up and start thinking, you know what I'm saying, and praying and trying to get out the situation they in right now. You know what I'm saying? Because you know God good.
God is good. So the situation that you're saying is if you happen to be staying with your mom, right, and I do have people call me talking about they're staying with their mom, and the mom gets ill and has to go to assisted living, yeah, or something happens between you and your mom and she puts you out of the house or something, or you're not following the rules in the house, right? The best thing advice you're saying is get your own.
Pretty much. Pretty much. And also, today her birthday.
Your mother's birthday?
Yeah, today my mom's birthday.
All right, you want to say hello to her?
Hello, mama. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, mama.
But they just need to start thinking, man, because this is a drug war, man. This people, you know what I'm saying, doing drugs out here.
All
right. They don't want to, you know what I'm saying?
Right. So some people who are homeless, some of the choices they make, some people are affected by choices other people make.
Right.
Right. And some are medicating, and this is the truth, some are medicating through drugs the pain they're going through.
Right? Yeah, they trying to escape the pain. You know, that's the wrong thing to do because, you know what I'm saying, God is almighty.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? They should have closed their eyes and prayed for real.
Right. And we want, you know, there's all kinds of addictions. Now, there's a runner addiction that's supposed to be positive, right? If you run, some endorphins are released, right? There's a book addiction that's good for you, right?
Yeah.
But I like to say, out of all the addictions, there's a positive addiction, have a Jesus addiction.
Yeah.
Right?
But so you don't have Jesus addiction. Okay. Right. You know what I'm saying? That drug controlled in them. That's Satan.
Okay. So let's say a prayer for our homeless brothers and sisters. Heavenly Father, we lift up our homeless brothers and sisters. Heavenly Father, those who are without shelter, those who are enslaved by sin, which is the ultimate addiction. But also, Heavenly Father, from that, they're also trying to medicate themselves, medicate the pain, Heavenly Father. We ask you that they come to you, the knowledge of you, Heavenly Father, and know that you are the way maker. You are the chain breaker, and you can rescue them. You are our deliverer, Heavenly Father. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, and the first and the last. And we worship you, and we lift you up, Heavenly Father, and we ask you to help our brothers and sisters who are less fortunate. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Ronald, I want to thank you for being here today.
Oh, yeah, right? You know, you have a great day.
You have a great day here today. You're going to get several items that you need, right, and a great meal.
Yeah, I thought he gonna pet. No, this, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know what I'm saying? I love this pep rally Levy Rice have. You know what I'm saying? This ain't the first time I came, and you know that.
Yeah, I know. But we're always gonna be here for you.
Okay.
Right? Just like Jesus, we're always gonna be here for you.
Tell everyone your name.
I'm Jenny.
Jenny and?
Mary.
Okay, why do you want to help people? You guys are helping out, but I know you that you love Jesus, and it's made a difference in your life. Is that right?
It's made a huge difference in my life, yeah.
Wow. How's it made a difference in your life?
To help people or to know Jesus?
Christ, yes. What's he
done? Well, now I have no fear of where I'm going when I die, which is huge. So I would say I don't have a fear of anything anymore. Like I would have if I didn't know him. You know, and I have, like, hope and there's promises. I mean, I could go on and on and on, but I mean...
And so
it's
knowing
like all
him,
the things we get...
As your Lord and Savior changes everything.
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
It changes everything.
Give hope.
Yes.
You know, there's anything that you need in this life, you know there's a way to get it. You know, it's not like we're his kids. He's like our dad.
Right.
So...
Being his child changes everything.
Oh, absolutely. That's where the sparkle in your eyes comes from.
You know, what I really think about is that I want to do what he wants me to do, so when I get up there, he'll be happy.
No.
So he said that when I was poor, you know, you fed me. When I was hungry, you fed me. When I was thirsty, you gave me water to drink. And when people say, no, God, we didn't do that for you. And he said, if you did it for the least of these, you did it for me.
Jesus, amen. We're saved by grace. But once you're saved by that grace, you want to get out there. You want to share with everybody. You want to help everybody. And you want to be obedient to the Lord, don't you?
Right.
So just to
kind of, absolutely.
Yes. And that's what he does. Yeah, when you really come to know the Lord, you're excited about getting out there and sharing the good news, and God bless you ladies for just doing just that, okay?
Thank you.
Thanks
for having this opportunity.
Yes. Thank you, folks.
Much. Keep on sharing the good news.
I'm here with Geraldine. Geraldine, you're here for this fantastic giveaway for a reason.
Because it's the season to be given.
Okay. And we believe that the season to be given is not
just the holidays, right? It's every day as Christ would do.
Right. Right? Correct.
Okay. You're here with your family members also?
Yes, I'm here with my daughter, my niece, my nephew, my great niece, and my great nephew.
Okay. So what does it mean to be giving? And we're not talking just this season. Giving should be something we do every day, right?
Correct. We should give every day because God gave his life for us, and we should also give for him.
Right, and God says be like him.
Yeah.
He came as the light of the world, and he said, you be lights also. All right, so when we do give from our heart, we're actually imitating and acting as Christ and the Christ that lives inside of us, right?
Correct.
Okay. You're a Christian.
Yes, I am.
You believe in Jesus Christ?
Yes, I do.
And he's your Lord and Savior?
Yes, he is.
Okay. Can you pray for us today?
Yes, I can.
Okay. I want you to pray for those who are homeless.
Okay.
Without shelter. Mm-hmm. And those who are seeking the Lord. Okay.
Father God, we come to you today in your name, Lord Jesus. We ask that you reach out and touch each and every one of us, Heavenly Father. Father God, we ask that you bless those who are less fortunate than us, Lord Jesus. We ask that you watch over the homeless. We ask that you watch over the ones that are fortunate to give, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, do you, your will be done. We ask and we shall receive, you said, Lord Jesus. Lord, we just asking you to reach out and touch this organization and just touch lives, Lord Jesus. Lord, we know through you anything is possible. We know that through you, Lord Jesus, everything could change, Heavenly Father. Father God, I just thank you, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Lord. Father God, I just thank you. Father God, we just ask you just reach and touch each and every individual up in here, Lord Jesus. Thank you for letting them have a giving heart, Lord Jesus. Let them have a giving spirit, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, please, please, Lord Jesus, please. Reach out, reach down, and touch each and every one of your children, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
Lord Jesus, everything that we ask for, we know you will provide, Lord Jesus. And it's in your name's sake, we continue to pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen. I want to thank you for being here. I want to thank you for bringing your friends and your family here today. And it's just a wonderful sensation. If you don't know what the sensation is about giving, there's a thing called random acts of kindness, where people just keep doing. It could be picking up a flower, right, and giving it to somebody, right? It could be just saying good morning to someone and saying, God loves you, right? It's just random acts of kindness are actually being like our Lord, who came from heaven, right? All the way down to earth, became man and became God, right? And died on Calvary. And was resurrected to give us what? To give us hope. And to set an example. He's a perfect example of always giving, always loving, always being patient, always being kind, always being joyful. And that's what we want to be. We want to mirror him. We want to be his lights.
Yes.
Right. So I thank you for being here today. Right.
Thank you.
And we're going to be opening. We're going to be opening up very soon. It's going to get started very soon.
Yes.
So I'm excited. Right.
Yes.
And we have all kinds of things for you today.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
God bless you.
God bless you too.
What's Jesus done for you?
Oh, Jesus snatched me. He gave me what I don't deserve. No, he gave me what I don't deserve. He gave me what I do not deserve. And he hasn't given me what I do deserve.
Amen.
And I am now 17 years old. I got born again in 2001.
Yeah.
And he made me a new child of his.
Great.
And
great.
I am just so excited to be able to come up here and help you, great, Reverend Rice, and all that you do. And just thank you for being a great example for us to follow.
Well, we're
following him.
Jesus is so good. You know, a lot of people say, I want to get what I deserve. Well, hey, if we got that, you'd get hell.
Yeah.
But thank God he didn't do that. He gave us heaven instead.
Yep. Hallelujah.
Jesus, right?
Yeah.
And so when you come to know him, you know his power, you know his love, you want to get out there and tell everybody that good news, don't you?
Everybody.
Yeah.
And I want everyone to know, unless you are born again, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. So this is something that we got to ponder in our hearts.
Yes.
We got to ponder this in our hearts because hell is going to be full of people that think that they were good enough. And none of us are good enough. Jesus said, none is good, no, not one. Just as the rich man came up to him and says, what must I do, good teacher? He said, none is, Jesus replied.
So, give it to the poor, just come to the kingdom of God,
give it
for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. all that we have is His blessings. All that we can do is just respond and just love and share and thank God for a second chance.
Right? Yep, yep, and not giving us what we deserve. And I want everybody just to remember to be praying for Larry Rice here and this ministry, because this is some awesome stuff. And God is going to prevail, so don't ever lose heart.
Amen. God bless you.
Good morning. I'm Nadine Rice, and I thank the Lord for blessing me to be here again with Reverend Rice and the New Life Evangelist team. They're doing a great thing. They did this on Thanksgiving Day, and we had a super turnout, and I was blessed to be here with the homeless, and even non-homeless people are coming in and volunteering their services with New Life Evangelists and encouraging Reverend Rice and Reverend Ray and the New Life staff coming out to participate and give gifts and food and all and communicating. And we just thank the Lord for that. And you all continue to pray for Reverend Rice and the New Life Evangelist team, that the Lord will bless him to be able to continue helping the homeless and whoever else that's needed that's not even homeless, and giving out bus tickets and helping with jobs and food and housing. He's more than just Reverend Rice. Thank you, and keep us in your prayers.
Tell us, what does Christ mean to you? How does the love of Christ motivate you to want to help others?
Well, and it goes back to a recent sermon that I had where it talks about giving. Yes. What did God give? His only begotten Son. Did He ask for anything in return? Only to believe in Him. That's what Christmas is to me.
Praise God. And that's not just something on December 25th as we move into this new year. It's all year long. Tell everyone your name.
Mike Pinson.
And Mike, what do you do?
Retired. Mm-hmm. So just
praise God. And you just want to share the love of Christ.
I love it. I love it.
Well, we thank you for being willing to do that and sharing your gift that you did today. And Jesus makes all the difference in the world, doesn't He?
Yes, He does.
Can you imagine living in this world without Christ?
How did they exist prior to Christ? And they had testimonies about His coming, but yet it was difficult.
I love that passage from Peter, because I see them when Jesus is dying on the cross, all the demons of hell just celebrating, they think they got Him, and suddenly there's this knock at the door of hell. They open it, and there's Christ. He's come down to preach to the prison captives there to liberate the people, blowing the minds of the demons.
Very much. Very much. Yes. Love it.
The resurrection of Christ changed everything.
Yes, it did. And thank goodness that He did that.
Amen. And when it happens, it changes our life, and we want to go help others, right?
But the important thing is He rose from the dead, and He's there for us.
And He's there for you.
Everybody.
He's there for everybody. If you haven't called on the name of the Lord, the Bible says, as many as call upon the name of the Lord shall be called the children of God. I want to encourage you to call upon Him now and experience His love and power.
We're going to pray. Let's thank Him. Let's say thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For sending Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
For us.
Dying for the cross for us.
Yes.
Taking our sins from us.
Yes, Mama.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we ask you to bless this room today and each one that's right in this room. Thank you, Almighty God, for the miracle that you're doing at this time. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Cynthia came by and stopped me. For what reason?
To just thank you guys for helping us this year and making our life easy, and I appreciate it.
Cynthia, what did you find here today?
I found gloves and coats and blankets and toys for the babies.
Okay. And things you needed.
Yes, sir. Very much needed.
Well,
yes.
We do this for a reason, Cynthia, and the gifts are all fine, right?
Yes.
And the things you need are all fine,
yes,
right? But we do it to show the love of Jesus Christ.
And I love my Jesus.
Okay.
I do go to church.
I like hearing that.
I love my Jesus, and I love serving my Jesus. I love helping people every day. And that's why we are here, to help one another, you know, and people have to notice that. When we see people on the street, I give them a dime or two, a dollar. It don't matter what they do with it. God say help one another.
That's right.
God says help the least of these and help one another.
Yes, sir.
And he says by doing this, you've done it unto Jesus.
Yes, sir.
That's how important it is. It's not an option. It's a commandment.
It's a yes, sir. It definitely is a commandment. And we need to help our homeless more. We need to be out here giving people and loving people, no matter what they race, creed, or color. And I just want to say one more time, thank you, Jesus, and I love everybody.
Well, you can stop me anytime to say thank you.
All right.
Okay, thank you very much, Cynthia.
All right.
My name is Laquita, and Jesus is my Lord and Savior, my personal Lord and Savior.
How has that changed the way you live your life?
Oh, my God, it changed a lot. I mean, I can honestly say before I allowed him to come into my heart, I was basically a walking dead and didn't know it.
Wow.
I was a walking dead and didn't know it.
Miserable.
Even though I've always had a good heart, I've always tried to make a difference in people's lives and everything, but I was literally a walking dead and didn't know it. My whole mindset has changed. My whole mindset has changed. My whole outlook on life has changed.
Wow, yes, it does. It's just mind-blowing. I mean,
and if
you've never received Jesus, you're not going to have a clue what we're talking about. Mm-hmm. But then you enter this relationship with the Creator and Redeemer, the universe, mm-hmm. and your eyes are open. You walk around, and wow, you start noticing the sky, and you start mm-hmm. noticing the animals mm-hmm. and the plants and, mm-hmm. and other people, and uh-huh. you start to become alive.
Yeah, yeah. And when I can honestly say a new birth, even though I was a grown woman, and it happened in like 1999
yes.
toward 2000, even though I was a grown woman, I literally became a new person in Christ Jesus, born again as an adult. And that is the truth.
Yeah. And it can happen to you. And we can help you with this. You want to grow in the Lord, you can go to LarryRiceMinistries.org. We got all these different teachings there. You want to help other people, call us 314-421-3020 or follow us on Facebook at NLECSTL.org. And just discover the joy of also helping other people once you experience Jesus.
That's right. Because whatever I do, whether it be little or much, it's not about me. It's about He gets the glory. In all things. It's not about me. I'm just a vessel.
Yeah, we don't want to be glory robbers. We got to give it to Him. He deserves all glory, honor,
and praise.
That's
right.
If we start sucking in too much of that, we better sit back. We better repent and
that's right.
and just move forth under His guidance and direction, experience mm-hmm. the light and love of Jesus shining
yes.
through us, right?
Yeah, and I'm blessed. I am truly blessed. And not only... I'm not a selfish, blessed person. I want to be a blessing to others in my own way, doing what I know, what He wants me to do. I want to be a blessing to others because I am truly blessed.
You can be truly blessed too. Call upon the Lord, experience His light, experience His love, and watch Him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think.